now, right now. Now, right now. Now, right now. What is up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. All right, so we're gonna be talking about TradeFinex a little bit. We're gonna be talking about R3 Voltron, what they've been up to, what they've been changing. All right, so Standard Chartered invests more money into newly rebranded TradeFinex startup, that is Voltron, and it rebranded itself. It's now called Contour, C-O-N-Tour, which is fine. Voltron kind of sound kind of techy. I kind of liked it, edgy, but Contour is more professional, I guess. It's fine with me. So Standard Chartered has invested an undisclosed sum into Contour, a Corda-based blockchain trade platform to streamline transaction settlement processes. So it talks about how the pilots were good, and it talks about which claim reduced processing time for LOCs, letters of credit, from 2 weeks to just under a day, multiple pilot projects helped by TradeFinex, obviously. And it's talking about letters of credit, just for so you guys to know what it is. Letters of credit are bank back payment guarantee, transferable proof the seller will get the money owed, basically. And then this used to be all on paper, but now they're trying to go digitalized fully. They are an integral part of cross-border commerce, yet according to Contour, LOCs can take up to 10 days to process and settle. That's pretty great. So they rebranded themselves. It says the opportunity is huge. The opportunity cost in TradeFinex is huge. Carl Wagner, the CEO, said that. It said trillions of dollars in commodities, products, and services are transacted daily, but the sector is characterized by slow, duplicable, and expensive processes. Yeah, so you're trying to change some things. So Contour delivers a network where trusted information is shared in a real-time, efficiently digitalized letters of credit across all users in the transaction. Great. So what else I'm gonna get into on this? R3 run trade trial of 50 banks and firms. Indicated Voltron could improve their finance processing. I think I talked about that before. Newly rebranded company will seek to capitalize on a settlement. Later this year, according to Wagner, the company is now focusing on scaling the network with more banks, which is great, corporates and partners, and we look forward to continuing to collaborate with our growing community. And it says, GCR reported Contour will launch a commercial version of the product in the second half of 2020 and plans to build out its technical staff in the interim. Yes, it's interim. So that's pretty good. So second half 2020, they're going to commercialize. They're going full throttle. I think they're going to probably like push out more instead of like piloting, being on the edge a little bit, because they piloted, they tested it, it works. Now it's time to get like, go at it. That's time for them like, get going, basically. I feel like the wheel's going, basically, you could say. So, this one first. So it says Voltron moves into full commercialization, rebrands its Contour. So I just wanted to read a little paragraph at the end. So it said the plan is now for a full. I want only this. Yeah, only that. Yeah, only this. Yeah. The plan is now for a full production launch in the second half of the year. We will be going into beta, which means that we won't do any more one-off pilots. Wow, no more one-off pilots, no more testing, you know, on eggshell. So because we know the solution works and it works well, and customers have been asking us to do more transactions, says Wagner, with financial backing from his shareholders, Contour now has big hiring plans over the next 3 months. Wow, as it seeks to bring in technical and implementation talent to create the infrastructure necessary to scale up the project. So basically, they have to amp up their employees. They have to amp up things to do things right, because their customers, their shareholders are wanting more. They want this things to start rolling because everything works. The testing is working. Let's just get this thing rolling, basically. So just like Ripple, they had to hire a whole bunch of people. It's time for them to hire a whole bunch of people. I didn't want to just say Ripple. I just wanted to refer with somebody, a different company. Because Contour is a company and it has a CEO. So that's basically it I want to read. So I just want to put this in there. TradeFinex, which is Zenfin. on their website has this letters of credit, because some people be like, how does letters of credit has to do anything with TradeFinex? So right here, instrument support, letters of credit, TradeFinex network offers a decentralized way to manage letters of credit and electronic presentations. Buyers, sellers, banks, and carriers can electronically exchange letters of credit. So digitally, basically, with letters of credit, it says that. And then at the bottom, it shows all these like guarantees, bill lading, invoice stuff, receivables. This is what they support. And then it says on the platform it will be on at the bottom, it is TradeFinex, not TradeFinex, TradeShift, QuickBooks, Corda, and Oracle. So that's where Corda connects with Contour. And then also, I lost it. So I think I know where it's at. Anyway, so on this website, WTO.org, I did World Organization video a while ago. But I just want to just put this in this video for people to connect the dots. I'm getting close. All right, it's a network of networks. Usually when it says network of networks, there you go. So network of networks does not see competition, only interoperability. That's cool. All right, so TradeFinex. So some people, well, I was going to go into like the whole Swift thing, but it says right here, TradeFinex consists of a company with underlying network backed by a community of 11,000 members. When they say that, that is they talking about they're backed by Swift, you guys. Like, come on. Swift got 11,000 banks and company corporation together. They, like, everybody knows it's 11,000. That number is not like, it's 11,000. So, what I want to get into is where it says the project is currently live with receivables discounting and has plans to introduce letters of credit by 2020. It is 2020, you guys. They introduced it. They've been working on it. Voltron, which is now Contour, has been using it, has been piloting, and it's been working. So, yeah, so they've been getting down and doing some work. I'm proud of them. I'm happy. I'm excited for the second quarter of 2020, and that's all I have for this video. Please like, subscribe, share, notification buttons, all that good stuff. Yeah, that's all I have for you guys. Peace. See you guys at the next one. I will be posting more because I've been lazy, but I promise I will not be lazy this week. I'm trying to organize myself a little bit more, and that's probably the problem. All right, that's it. I'm gonna leave. Peace.